This is part two of modeling this cutaway hospital operating room. And I think what I want to do is I want to lengthen this wall and the floor. So I've got a bit more room over here. All right, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to come in here and select the face there, look from the top. And I think I'm just going to pull it down until I'm happy with the size of that. I think I'm just going to make it like that. This can always be changed, so I'm going to come in here now, and I'll select these two faces, and I'm going to switch to snapping, and I'm going to go to edge, and I'm just going to pull this down and try to snap it to there. Okay, I'm going to turn off snapping now, and I'm going to look from the front or the side or wherever the heck I am. I'm going to, in wireframe, I'm going to box select this, and I'm just going to pull this down like that. I'll come out of that object. Let's grab the parts of the door frame, and the handle, and we'll slide it into rough position. Let's try that. I think that auto work will give him some more room down there. So we got this plane here, and we'll have that extending part. It's the square, just sort of simple shapes. Let's figure out what we're gonna do to make this happen. Get the approximate size. I'm gonna bring the cursor there, and I'll bring in a plane. So it looks like it takes up about half. A simple shape, and I'm messing around with this thing. And that's pretty much a square in the middle area. So I'll be me. Later, I'm going to inset this. I'm going to bring it down a bit. I don't know if I needed to bring it down. I don't think I do, actually. I'm just going to extrude it up. That'll be the black piece there. And then it'll just go into the bed, which I might make separate. extend out past the legs, it does. And more here. The whole thing is sort of slid down like this. Something like that. Well, let's take that and separate it anyhow. Let's do that at first. It's hard to tell if that lies right above it, so I don't think that matters that much. There's another piece under there, I can't quite tell. Okay, let's take this piece here. And in wireframe, I'm going to, first of all, deselect. I'm going to pull this out. Don't need that. I'm going to pull this down. And we'll see how far down is that first pillow goes. Less than there. And then I can take this next one. It goes quite a bit up. Yeah. Makes sense. I'm not sure how big, so I'll just take this one. And then I'll make this one bigger. Like that. And we'll see if this is good enough. Thank you. else looking in here? I think that's okay for that bed. Do I need to be doing any more rounding? I don't think it's going to work very well if I do. I think I'm gonna like that better in the end, so I think this is gonna have to be the way we do it. You may not like that, but I do. Yeah. Let's hide that and let's copy this over and see. I do it this way. If I like it. Well, that's what we're gonna do. Possible that I want to do that on this as well. I don't know. Okay. We got wheels to do. Let's focus on this guy. Let's take that. Shift S, cursor selected. And let's bring in a circle. And we'll go for, I don't know, 18 vertices. Rotate X90. Now, how big are these wheels? Reasonably big. Okay, well, let's go E and S. Is there an inside to them? No, oh, but there's that thing coming. I know what to do. Let's fill it. Do this. Let's take this and bevel. Put one edge. We'll do subdivision. And I wanted to do. How do I want to do this? Yeah, I'm going to take this edge. Shift D, pull it out here and separate it, and then I'm going to go in to that thingamajig and vertex. I was thinking of getting rid of those vertices and taking these, extruding them up. I'll have to make a face. Let's go E and S. Let's do it this way. Let's bring it out. Okay, so I'm messing around. I'll get rid of the subdivision surface for now. Can I grid fill this? No. Okay, it doesn't matter. E and Alt, I don't care. Issues with this. for something so simple, but I could chop off the top too. Can I get anywhere in there? No, not really. So the best I can do is this. All for the bed, I think. So I think I'm gonna join that all together. Not join, but group. Does that look too small in that room? I think maybe. Shift G, select the group, and let's just scale it like this. A little hard to tell. Okay, that's good enough though. Or is it too high? Because these other instruments are going to be above it to some extent. It's hard to tell. Think that'd be better. Okay. Yep. I think I should do this thing. It's hanging on the ceiling. Cute. So we'll make a circle and we'll come down and we'll expand it and we'll come off. Or we'll copy and we'll bridge. I'm not sure what we'll do. I'm gonna go above that though. Extrude it down. Scale it out a bit. Extrude it down some more. We'll flip it all. Is it looking too big? Not high enough. And scale shift Z to make it a bit thinner. I'll close this up. ENS, and then I'm going to grid fill. Okay, I'm going to assume that these are the same diameter. One is maybe shorter than the other. So I think I'll just take this circle and I'll do something. I'll control L to link those. I'm not sure what I want to do here. I have an idea though. So it's up there and it's down there. Okay. This piece doesn't go right to the top of that, and it might be actually in the middle. So I was thinking I would do two edge loops here and scale them in the Z pretty close. And this one is like, it's gotta be longer, and it's closer to the top. It's never gonna be the same size. It doesn't matter though, I don't think. Where am I? So there's end on there, right? Okay. Because I don't want it all the way to the very top. Start again. The right one. Sorry for this. Control E, bridge edge loops. Let's try it. Oh, that's what I wanted. can't always think well when I'm on camera. I don't always know what I'm doing. Doesn't matter, but now this one is shorter than this one. What am I doing there? Surface, however, hopefully it'll come together. Okay, and then that comes out. Okay, so then I really think this is gonna have to go up higher than the room even for it to work. Well, whatever. What I'm gonna do, I think, is I'll take one of these circles. Shifty. I'm gonna break it. There it is. I'll go in and I'll just hit S to scale it. Pretty big. I'm just gonna rotate this. I'm gonna move it over to like here. Actually, before I rotate it, I'll do what I need to do. Move all of that so that we're kind of focusing on the middle, I think. No, we're gonna focus up at the three quarters up like that. So this guy is like a light. So we'll just make something here. Let's go E and S. And let's come out and scale in maybe E and S. And we'll grid fill that. Gonna do much with it. We're not gonna see that part. We'll bevel that. Not sure I like that bump there, but it's all right because we'll. Too much. This guy let's come back here. We'll work on you. Throw some edge loops in here. Everything up. If I try to go in here, you're gonna mess up my circle. I have a feeling you are. It's not too bad. It's not really noticeable or anything. Well, on the other hand, maybe it is. Okay, so what I'm gonna do, I think what I'm gonna do is I am gonna break with tradition and I am going to spam my selection by one. Can I hide everything but you? How horrible would it be to do this? You know? How? Very horrible. Probably not the way to do it. But it might be the way that I'm going to do it anyhow. It may not join very nicely. I don't think anyone's gonna see that and know any different. And that's what I'm gonna do. Sorry. Forgive me, but I'm doing it. Alright. It's done. It's over. Let's move on. What are we doing here now? So it was gonna come down and it was gonna do that thing. And I'm gonna do that part first, right around the back of this thing. So let's take this, make sure we've got that and shift S cursor selected, and let's bring in a plane. And let's scale it a bit and go with a vertex. Let's get rid of those vertices, so I have just those, right? Okay, so what is it I want to do? I want to come out, I want to go down. I'm not sure, like, I've never modeled this before, so I'm not sure I have the vision yet, but I think I did. I'm going to come out to around, like, the middle, and then I'm going to come down. Adjust these, all these positions in a bit. Let's get rid of the faces. Yeah, so let's get rid of that edge. Yeah. So like right into the middle. So you can see there. So it's like this part. Oh, it doesn't come down now on that side, only on one side. Right, of course. So was that joined, right? Okay, so we'll do this. We'll get rid of that edge. I still want to be in it. This one, I'm just going to get rid of that vertex. This one comes in. I'll make this a tube in a while. So, is that enough space? Yeah, so it comes out, goes up, goes around, and is there. So to the front, and then it's like up, straight? Yeah. And then we'll get the positioning of all these, and then up straight, kind of like that. Let's come out and we can get a sense of it. I feel like I need more room on that side, but I don't really. I know it is a bit of a tight curve. I was a carpenter, no. So how could this possibly... Oh, it doesn't have to be that high, maybe. Was there. It's a pretty short amount that goes into that. How far down? I'm going to do that. Sorry, you're way above the room. All right. I'm going to select all these sharp points here. And I'm going to go Control-Alt-B. And I'm going to bevel them. Put a couple of segments in there like that. And I'm going to convert to a curve. Full. Start increasing the bevel and the resolution and smooth. And just get us approximate size that I would want. That looks right. We'll rotate that. We move the whole thing. That's how I was thinking of doing it. Didn't put much of a curve there, and that could be done again. I don't think I have a lot of success curving this more after the fact. Not really too worried about that. I got other things to worry about. Let's try rotating this. I see. Okay, so maybe I need it. Well, no, it's got to spin around. I felt like the light is closer to this, but no, it's got to be able to spin in there. So it's got to be like that. This just doesn't look right. I mean, when you look from that point of view, like that. Now, you know, seems awfully darn close. What can I do to bring this whole thing up? You know, to bring this up short of putting this, you know, through the clouds. What am I missing? Or is it just the way it is? No, that doesn't look right to me. Neither is that. By the way, yeah, I think of where it is. Well, yeah, that's okay. But it's still up high, isn't it? Jesus. Jeez. Pardon my language. I just want to do a quick test of this. My scale have been off. still pretty darn close to the patient. So here's what we're going to do. It doesn't do a lot. Gives me a bit. But that's what we're going to do. And that's what we got. All right. This part has obviously got to be filled. Not that we're going to see it anyhow. I might just do it like that. Another one. I think that's what we're going to go with. Shortening that. It's not the same. I can change that later if I want to. The whole thing looks wimpy to me now. I think we're just gonna go with that for now. And we'll move on to something else. That was cool but frustrating. Very cool, very frustrating. I want to do something simple like these. If you don't mind, for the time being, just to make me feel better after doing that. So what's going on here? So what do I got? 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, I made this and the Y. Okay, when that happens, you gotta go Control A, rotation and scale. Make sure you set your scale. Okay, too big. That can be adjusted. I feel better now. Let's have a look at what this would look like. I think if I was to render it from, say, this point, like something like this, I think I can raise this up and it'll still look like it's there. I think it's just because we're looking in 3D. And therefore, my friends, we return to this and we make this nicer. No, not like that. I'll approve it. Yeah. La, 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 whatever. Now we come back to this and we find our spot.